Hi guys, welcome to my channel. So today I'm going to share with you this video right here. It's a one brand tutorial and I'm going to use all the products from Wet n Wild. So if you want to know how I like it and how the products fare on my skin, please keep on watching. So starting off, I'm using this Wet n Wild primer. This is a very nice primer when this comes to moisturizing, priming and setting. So it's a 3-in-1 primer. I've used it as a primer over here. I'm going to massage it onto my skin. Moving on, I'm using this Wet n Wild concealer. So as you know, these are my favorite concealers. They are good on coverage and they do the work very light on your skin, so they don't feel even heavy on your skin. I'm going to apply it to the usual areas like my under eyes. I'll clean my eyebrows with it. Also, I'll apply it on the marks and spots that I have on my face. So I'm using 2 concealers here. All the shades and everything will be mentioned in the description box. As you can see also, one is a lighter shade and one is more towards my shade. This is a contour stick from Wet n Wild that I'm going to use to contour the hollows of my cheeks, the forehead, also bridge of my nose, chin area. I'm blending it with this round brush. So these are very easy to blend also. So it does your work very easy. You can use just this and powder your face and call it a day. So that is how good this concealers are. I'm just making sure that everything is nicely blended over here. Moving on, this is the foundation that I'm going to use today. This foundation is one of the best foundation in the market right now. From the coverage, to the finish, to the look that this foundation gives to your face, it's unreal. It makes your skin look so smooth and just like a canvas where you can draw and paint. You will see the finished look after I apply this foundation. The coverage is really good. And people with a dry skin type can just use a moisturizer before applying this foundation. The shade range is also pretty good of this foundation. So I totally recommend this foundation. Moving on, I'm going to use this contour to contour palette. So these has 2 colors, as you saw, a lighter shade and a contour shade. So I'm going to set my face with the yellow powder. It's a really nice powder. It's very finely milled and does not give any flashbacks. Using the same palette, I'm going to contour the face. I'm going to apply the contour powder to the areas where I had applied that stick. It's a really, really nice powder duo. Moving on to my blush, I've broken this blush into pieces, like I've shattered it, but this is such a nice blush. It's called Mellowed Wine and it goes with my skin tone so well. I really love the blush. The pigmentation and everything is really nice. So a very big yes for this blush too. Moving on to my highlighter, this is the Wet n Wild Mega Glow Highlighter. And I don't have to say anything about this highlighter because it's all the rage in the market. So it's a really pretty highlighter, the shade and everything. So as you can see, I was so happy applying the highlighter that I went overboard. Like, that's the thing with the highlighter, you can go overboard. It's a really pretty highlighter. I'm going to use this palette, it's called Rose in the Air, for my eyes. This is for the transition shade that I'm going to do. I'm planning to do a funky eyes, so this is just for the transition shade. I'm going to apply it on the crease area of my eyelids. I'm using this Quad palette from Wet n Wild, and I'm going to use this blue turquoise color and apply it all over my eyelid. The pigmentation with Wet n Wild palettes are really good, so if you want to invest in something affordable yet does the work, you should apply Wet n Wild. You should buy Wet n Wild. Taking the lighter shade of Transition, and I'm going to blend it. All the eyeshadow and everything is quite blendable of Wet n Wild, and they don't have much of fallout also. I'm just going back and forth. I'm taking this purple color and I'm going to apply it on my lower lash line. This is a very funky look, but yet you can wear it outside, so it's not that out of the box look. Taking the lighter shade, I'm going to apply it on the inner corners of my eyes, also brow bone. This is a eyeliner, but I'm not a very big fan of this eyeliner because it doesn't completely dry out. Like, I don't know, it's a really nice eyeliner, the tip and everything, but I don't like it that much. The mascaras from Wet n Wild are good, but not that great. At least not the one that I'm applying right now. Moving on to my lipstick. So unfortunately, I had only just this one color, and this color was not going that well with the eye look. So I decided to lighten it with a concealer that I had from Wet n Wild. I'm going to just mix it and make a very light shade of pink that goes with the eyeshadow. And I'm applying it on my lips with the help of my fingers. It's a very light and very blushed look for the lips. I'm going to set my face with the same primer water that I used before. It's in the variant Cucumber, and I'm going to dry out my face. It's a really nice primer water, and it does the work of setting also nicely, sponging out my face. And that's it for the final look. So guys, this is how I achieved this look. I love all the products that I've used today. They are like my holy grail product, and I love this brand because of its pricing point, it's cruelty free, and it's all a win-win situation. So if you like this video and if you like this look, please give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to comment and share this video and subscribe to this channel. Bye.